you're gonna hug each other.
Surfing in the last 2 or 3 years.
Watching the different approaches. It's probably the most special event because there's no prize money. You know, affluent halfway around the world is not getting this event. Whether I came first or last didn't make any difference. It's about the pure love and joy and celebration of surfing big waves. It's a passion, it's something we're addicted to. Riding big waves and being part of the ocean and being in touch with nature. It's something, you know, some people take drugs, some people jump off cliffs. We take on big waves and there's nothing that comes close to that. Paid 20,000 rand that I don't even have, at risking possibly my relationship with my girlfriend, my job, and I'm still here, and I'm stuck riding big waves.
Everything that I do in my life is to try and get into that place, and when I'm there, then everything makes sense. When I'm thinking that I do in my life is to be there.
A few of the guys that have got what it takes, you know. It's getting really competitive, and I think the guys that have been in these contests for a long time have got to watch their back.
A little bit of regret or just feels anxiety if they're not at the biggest spot on any given day, or at the, you know, getting the most out of a large swell and being on a giant wave. And you know, it's funny. I always try to think back, like, why do I do this? And I go back to one of the first sessions that I had in big waves where I decided it was what I wanted to do for the rest of my life. And it really wasn't the actual act of the weightless drop and like looking up at the huge wall or anything like that, but it's the feeling you get after the session where you feel that your body's completely spent at the biggest possible place, riding the biggest possible waves. That's the feeling that you're always chasing.